never know until you switch it on whether it's on or off. And the view is of something I think I owe to my friends, y'all from Loggerheads and from Loasis, because of all the musical talent you have. These gifts of wind and string, or metal, striking metal. In the piano, there's a metal string that gets struck. And in the guitar, of course, the strings get strummed. Or you blow wind. And sometimes you use a reed, like this practice piece from a bagpipe. Now, this one doesn't have a reed. It goes by the little channel of wind that vibrates. I think that's how it works, but I'm not sure. Well, you know, it goes like that. Thank you. move faster in my mind than I could ever play them because I'm not really that professional. And the camera's blinking at me. Seems to say there's a limit of memory. Well, all right then. I'll turn you off. Check later. My dog t-shirt. It's about 70 degrees outside here in Southern California, and it got cold last night, and it'll get cold tonight, down in the 40s, which is what we call freezing. I have only a few moments of time left in memory, so I thought I would just go ahead and make a little vlog for my friends at Loggerheads and Blue Oasis and YouTube and Vimeo. And let you know that I've applied for the Colorado. I made the deadline for the Colorado Prize for poetry. And then just this week I saw a message from New York about the Guggenheim and the American Academy of Poets putting on they're going to sponsor a poet in residence at the Guggenheim. And she or he will also work with the poetry group, American poetry thing. So I managed to meet that deadline too. I found out that eligible to apply because I had a chapbook published by somebody else, not by myself. And I have some by myself, but they don't count in this contest. And I also had been to many, participated in many spoken readings of poetry. So I decided, okay, I'll go ahead and apply. I sent them my, what they call the curriculum vitae or the CV, which is another word for resume, that is. And I sent them three things. The resume, CV, and a sample of my poems, 5 to 7 pages. I sent them 7 pages, actually. And that was interesting because I just picked some of the ones I'd worked on for months on the Colorado manuscript. Picked 3 or 4 of them. And 7 pages. And I also sent the proposed project that I would have as a poet in residence at the Guggenheim. They're going to make their choice and let people know by the end of February. So that's one thing. The Colorado Prize won't be announced until a little bit after that. But those are the two big things in my radar for the news I managed to do over the holidays and finish up in the first month of the new year, is get those applications in for some of the last contests I'll probably ever enter in my life, because I'm in my 70s now. Yeah, I'll be 74 in later this year in autumn. And that's when I hope, if I win, I would be in New York working, a working poet. It's hard to imagine such a thing. But there it is. There's my yellow teeth. Look at that. If I go to New York, I'll have to have new teeth put in. Ew. Those are ugly. Gotta paint them white. Okay. Bye-bye.